Hi there! Do you want to build an awesome prop to fit your awesome cosplay? Well, then I'm going to show you how to build this glorious bastard so you can even be a better walking Christmas tree. So, in this video, you're going to see how to build it. So what I first did was sculpting the crystal that I wanted. In the middle of it is already the PVC cube, which I will use later. So I want to make sure that it's perfectly round, so I use a chisel base cut and I just press it around that, so I had a proper base. So that as in just ordinary sculpting. So in the top of the staff there is just an orb, so I use those spares, those holders must cosplayers use for the booby armor. Well, I use it for this. So then it has the right shape, so that makes me very happy. So after that, I start building the foam box and pour the silicones in. The silicones I used were C20 silicones from Silicones and More. And as you can see, it is very easy to reuse the material by just cutting it in small pieces and just throw it in a mold and add silicones to it so that it can come apart. Which is kind of nice because it saves you a lot of money. So after the silicones dried out, I took out my sculpture and made it a smaller, with still the PVC tube in. Also, I took the yellow spare and filled it with monster clay and made it then a little bit smaller so I could guess the spare, other spare hollow. Put wrappings around and rubber bands so to prevent leaking, so it saves me a lot of material. And then of course the calculation on how much resin you need, I do it always with water and then just measure and recalculate how much I need. Please, for the love of God, yeah, you calculate twice, because the dipshit like me made 500 milliliters too much. So then you have the rest of the leads right, what the hell are you going to do with that? So I poured the silicones and I waited a few days. The most preferable in a bucket for in case there's a small leak, as you can see. Then you have your crystal and there's still monster clay inside of it. So what I do is just with the heat gun melt it out of it, or what you can also do to find out is you can put it back in the microwave and it just drips out and it doesn't damage your crystal. So that's also an easy thing to do that. After that I added plasticizer from Mink to diffuse the LEDs I will later add. So for the next part, which I didn't film because I was at Elvania Cosplay's place where she helped me. And please check her out because she's awesome. So what we did, with a crystal, which was hollow, we have two parts, we kitted it together. And for that we used a translucent, but also a flexible kit. And please, for the love of God, use a proper one because you don't want the thing to break off. Yeah? Please. So inside of that we used a wood bar, and around of it there is pre-programmed. With my steenkolen Engels, or how other people say, Dunglish. Let's strip. So, because of that, I didn't have to use an Arduino, which I really like because I don't have much space. So, the wood I use is also for extra support. So, because in the mold, I already use a PVC tube. So now I can just install another one, very easy, just pressing it through and it worked, and then just add a lot of kit. But then you have the problem then with the wire. Well, I cut the PVC tube open with a cutter and then I follow it by pushing it through and then just melt it back together with my heat gun. So that's that part. So after that, I started building the lower part of the staff, the bony details and such, which is made from CF56 foam chroming, and then covered in warp lab. And again, for more durability, because I'm really afraid it'll break due to massive weight, I made bony scales on PC chip from warp lab, so it is very durable now. And also, I made a little gap, so I can still use a remote, and then it has multiple options. Makes me happy. To dress up the crystal, I drew on it with a removable marker and just crafted the dragon with it with Warblast scraps. To make the wings more easy to transport, I connected them with super magnets. I attached the super magnets with super glue and also with kit. To make the tethered flash of the wings, well, I did the most fun thing that you can possibly do. Torture fabric. And believe me, this is fun, but please do it safe. And with safe, I mean I had a bucket of water next to me, because I was afraid I'm going to burn down my whole house. After that, I just primed it with wood glue, and then painted it, of course, but apparently the paint is a lot similar, like, so it was quite easy to paint and just add some highlights and low lights. So that's it, how you build this freaking amazing staff, which is too big. So that is how you build this freaking amazing staff, and you can also use it as a big scratcher. So I hope you enjoyed the video, and please subscribe and like or give a comment or something. I don't know what to say. But I just hope you enjoy it. See you next time.